Hello,
Oh
can
yeah,
you?
I'll do
Yeah.
that. Hello. Okay, hello everyone. I hope you're healthy and happy. So today we have here with us Mr. Yash Marwaji. He is a climate change campaigner, writer, and communication strategist. He is the co-creator of the volunteer-run Environmental Communications Collective, Let India Breathe, that runs awareness campaigns with communities affected by extractive development to educate people about ecological destruction. The collective has co-run multiple successive campaigns like Withdraw EIA Notification 2020, Save Molem, Save Array, etc. He is currently working on hashtag No Extensions to Polluters, a campaign to ensure thermal power plants reduce their emissions as per 2050 norms set by the Supreme Court. Over to you, sir.
Hi all, thanks so much for joining, and special thanks to Sprouts, FES, and all the amazing volunteers out here. So I think if you have my slide, we can just get into it.
Just give me a second. Yes, I'll share that.
Yeah. Meanwhile, if I can, you know, get some votes in the comments, zero being the least and five being the most, if all of you would want to perhaps vote how you stand on the social media scale. I think no one is zero because now we are on Zoom and WhatsApp at least, if nothing else. But I would love to have about 7-8 replies if possible from all of you. I mean, 7-8 in all, one from each. Quickly, in say about 10-15 seconds. And just in case you haven't already figured, this is going to be more of an interactive kind of a workshop. So we will keep talking to each other. Thanks, Dwiti. You all can just drop numbers. A sentence might be too much to ask for on a Saturday morning. So anyways, so this thing, this workshop of mine, it's called Eyeballs and Eardrums. And I'm calling it that because it's no more only about eyeballs, right? When you look at all the social media platforms and content platforms, right from, you know, our WhatsApp to so on and so forth, everything has a lot to do with audio also. So this workshop is about social media for sustainability. And I'll just skip to slide three because two has already been taken care of. Yeah, the next one, yeah. So because there's so much clutter, right? You have so many platforms, so many people, so many creators, so on and so forth, who keep talking about either their products, their services, or their thoughts and expressions and all of that on social media. It's very important for all of us to ensure that whatever we do stands out, and if not stand out, at least gets the right kind of attention it deserves. Because a lot of people here and also in the main session and in our especially the sustainability arena, I'm sure we are doing brilliant work, but because we are so much involved in how we do that work and how we ensure it happens properly, the presentation, or what you call in the capitalist sense the marketing of that, is somewhere we tend to lack, unless we have experts on board who can market it for us. Some of us are inborn marketers, so we don't really need that. And I'm sure none of us here would say that, hey, I don't know anything about marketing. So this is all about that. I'll just take you through some marketing jargon in the next slides. So the first one is obviously product, right? And your product can be anything from like a tangible product. Can I go to the next slide? Actually, if I can get the slide controls, I can also, you know, swipe it if possible. But yeah, so yeah, the first one is product, the second one is price, then we have place, and then we have promotion, right? So anyone who's done even basic marketing, you realize that these are very important things when it comes to marketing something. And so for the next one, we see product. And a lot of us in the sustainability arena, we tend to do things that are very unique, right? If we can go to the next slide. And जब तक हमारा प्रोडक्ट यूनिक है, दैट अरेना इज कॉल्ड ब्लू ओशन, राइट? एंड एज मोर एंड मोर पीपल स्टार्ट डूइंग द सेम थिंग, फॉर एग्जांपल बैम्बू टूथब्रशेस, इफ हंड्रेड्स ऑफ पीपल आर सेलिंग बैम्बू टूथब्रशेस नाउ 10 इयर्स आफ्टर यू नो फर्स्ट इट बिकेम अ फैड, you will have to differentiate in a way that ultimately it becomes a blue ocean for you again, right? So if your product is good and the right kind of audience already knows about it, you don't need a lot of marketing. Next one, price. So here I would just want to say that even for volunteer-run organizations, everyone is paying a price. Even volunteers are giving their time, right? So that is the price they pay. And the brain and the heart here that you see, the brain is basically the price you pay. It could be in terms of time or money. And the heart is how much value you get out of it, right? So it's very important for us as either creators or business owners or activists who run certain causes to know that anyone who's coming to us, either to buy our services or support our cause, needs to take some value out of it, right? So the next one is place. And in our context, in this particular presentation, the place is mostly social media or internet or digital. That's where all the distribution is happening. And the last one is promotion. And believe you me, right from advertising to sales to public relations to personal selling, all of this can be done on social media. And while so many people consider social media as a very mass media, I personally consider it as a very direct medium. You can actually interact with either your consumer or your fellow activist in your cause or your volunteer directly on social media, right? So that now the first bit, like, what do you know? Can we go to the next slide? What do you know about your audience, right? Who are they? What do they want? Where can you find them? And how can you help them? Is there anyone here who would want me to give a live example out of your particular case study? I'm happy to talk about it. You could be someone who runs an NGO or someone who runs a cause or anything. Otherwise, I will take my own examples, but I'll give you, say, half a minute to think about it. If anyone wants me to break this down based on your example, I'm happy to do that. And just in case the question is not clear, just say that. I am happy to repeat it again. But okay, so assuming we are here talking about an NGO that perhaps wants to raise awareness on how to ensure that people in a certain area will log on to eBird or something like a great, the bird count, right? So who is your audience here? So mostly your audience is going to be someone who understands birds or is at least fascinated by birds, right? And what do they want? They perhaps want just some appreciation. Ki, bhaiya, this person, in Virar has counted about 100 birds for this, census, bird census, which is happening across the city. Where can you find them? So obviously the first thing is, of course, Virar. But now on social media, you will perhaps go to Facebook groups about Virar. It could be Virar Classified. It could be Virar Local Train. You see all sorts of these Facebook groups. But on the other hand, you can go to Twitter handle like Virar Info. You can go to Instagram pages like some. There must be some pages that will say Arnala Fort is the best, right? So you need to ensure that you know all the key things around your audience, what they like, where you can find them. So right from Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, you have to basically ensure that, your audience, you know where to find your audience. That's very important. And finally, how can you help them? Because for example, if I, who perhaps likes birds and might know 5-6 exotic birds ka naam or name, I also perhaps need to have a binocular. I also perhaps need to have the eBird app or whichever app I need to log on my census on. I need to obviously know their calls or their color, where do I find them, which season, their size, et cetera, et cetera. So this is where, basically you'll put out all this information on, say, your Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest, et cetera. And you will realize that once you answer all these four questions for yourself, you will find the right fit of your audience, right? And frankly, even without money, like a lot of social media these days are about boosting your post for say 100 rupees, 500 rupees, 1000 rupees. I mean, it's just a rabbit hole. Jitna paisa hai, utna aap dal sakte hain uske andar. But if you play your cards right and join the right groups and talk to the right influencers, you can end up having your audience for free, right? And if you visit these places and perhaps take an offline workshop, and here is when I will just reiterate that online can never happen without offline, right? So these both go hand in hand. And if you have a strong product, which I said in the first slide, which is offline, it's very easy to get the same people online also to follow you on various social media. Then they can share it with their friends. You can then make them your ambassadors or evangelists, right? You can tell them how by sharing a post, they will basically contribute to the growth of your organization, entity, cause, whatever, right? And on the other hand, if you put out testimonials, say bird count ki wajah se, you know, there are some 5 top volunteers of Bombay. If you give them appreciation online, they will share that post also, right? And then their friends, family, etc. will come to know. So I'm just talking about remuneration does not always have to be like, you know, in cash. It can be in kind and stuff like that. And in an age when we are all seeking validation on social media, this is a very, very important and nice way to get traction for free. So I can go to the next. Yeah. Can you mute?
Yes, I have.
Cool. So the next one is like, you know, knowing your platforms. So if we can go to the next slide. Yeah. So we all possibly know Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. I think they are very, very famous in a way. Although we might, I mean, it's possible that many people on this call may not be on Twitter, but we know what's Twitter at least, right? And each of these mediums have their own strengths. Facebook, as I mentioned, groups are very, very important. Although in my personal opinion, organic reach on Facebook is now going down every day because there are so many people on that platform that your reach is being limited. And so when you join the right groups, let's come down to maybe Dadar, not Virar, Dadar. So something as lame as Dadar Vada Pav versus Kurla Vada Pav will also be a group. So don't hesitate in joining any of these groups. It could be something around, one of the beaches in Mumbai. It could be about Chopati. It could be about India Gate, Gateway of India. When you look at your audience and what they like, their likes, dislikes, etc., you can join the right kind of groups on Facebook and ensure that you can share your information there. And that's how you will find audience for your, you know, business, cause, entity, whatever. Instagram, excitingly, is one of the very visual mediums. And especially for something like a, you know, conservation organization and for someone who has a beautiful product, like, as I mentioned, bamboo toothbrushes, Instagram is the right place to be, because as many photos, videos, reels, etc. you will put out there, you will get more and more people to, you know, basically like your content and talk to you. And if you use the right tools, they can also keep coming to your website. You can even create shoppable content. You can create shops on Instagram, but that is for brands. But for people with cause, like, you know, causes and grassroots mobilization, etc., it's very important to know that because of the visual angle of your stories, you can get more and more audience on Instagram. I hope you all know about Fridays for Future, right? It's just a bunch of cool kids going out there and protesting. But when you see their photos from different parts of the country, be it in front of Environment Ministry in Delhi, or be it in front of, Gateway of India in Bombay, or any beach and so on and so forth, or even on a railway station, those photos motivate you to either be with them or at least share their story, right? And that is the first bit where you get engaged and you basically you start finding the pool of your audience. So Instagram is something I'm personally very excited about in the past one and a half years. So I can just go on and on, but Pinterest is a medium which maybe not all of us might know. And even if we do, we may not be using it for our day-to-day thing, right? But for someone who's perhaps building something, maybe an architect or an eco-builder or someone who has a product that can go on Pinterest, like you know, it could be furniture, it could be handicraft, it could be textiles, etc., etc. It's a very nice medium to be on, because you're the people who think like you are coming on Pinterest, right? I mean, I'm not saying this for causes or NGOs, but especially for products and eco-friendly ones, the people who think like you, and maybe even your competitors, they are all on Pinterest, you know. And it's possible you will say, no, my competitor is not, but okay, maybe not in India, but when you look at someone from you know, abroad, it could be Bangladesh, Pakistan, Philippines, France, like, you know, we can just go on and on. So all of these people are out there. You can perhaps learn how to present your stuff well on Pinterest. You will see a lot of designers come on Pinterest, a lot of art aficionados, they will come for, you know, tips and tricks and so on and so forth, how to declutter your space. I mean, all of that jazz you will find on Pinterest. So frankly, if anyone wants to start something on Pinterest, you can just mail me. I'll be happy to set that up for you. So that's that. Twitter is a medium which is important. If you remember, in, you know, on the promotion side, I talked about advertising, sales promotion, public relations, etc. Especially for public relations, it's very nice to be on Twitter, because right from your journalists to your decision makers, to celebrities, to influencers, you will find all of them on Twitter, right? And when you tag them, or in a, what activists do, when you harass them by tagging them many times online, you will basically get their attention. And it's highly possible that either a journalist or an influencer or a neta will talk about, you know, your cause if they align with it. And again, now we can go back to the audience bit. To understand, not every neta will, you know, talk about your cause. Not every influencer or an actress or celebrity is going to retweet what you have put out. But if you know them, right, like for environment, maybe someone like a Diya Mirza, someone like a Shraddha Kapoor, Tiger Shroff has also done it at some time, someone like Vishal Dadlani. When you know how your influencer thinks and you go to them on Twitter, it's highly likely that they are going to, you know, retweet your stuff, or going to talk to you, or DM you, or comment, or like, you know. Even a like from someone with 1 million followers can give a huge boost to your post in the, you know, Twitter algorithm. So that's that. Coming to LinkedIn, and assuming that there are some, you know, people who are either in businesses or in professionals who need some LinkedIn help, LinkedIn is definitely a great place to be, either as a person or as a business. It's very important for you to have a presence on LinkedIn for two reasons. One is network, right? So when you join, suppose I send a request to Anand, and Anand is Anand Pindarkar, and he's now my connection, at least 90% of his network then also becomes my network. That's how LinkedIn works. So that's why it's important for you to find people from your own domain. If you are into, you know, sustainable consultancy, just find maybe 5-10 great consultants in India and reach out to them. Mostly, in all probability, 80-90% of them will accept your request. But otherwise, find the same people who already know you, right? And join their networks, because then through them, you will join more groups, etc., etc. All that will happen. Can we go to the next slide? So here I will come with some, unconventional sort of mediums. The one before that, sorry. We know the other four, so I'll just talk about the first one. Moj or TikTok or Takatak are something like Instagram Reels. But in the heartland of India, in places where perhaps TikTok was a phenomenon, but now is not because it's banned, people are creating a lot of content on apps like Moj and Takatak. Right. It's basically just putting your video on a music and or some background, voice, something of that sort. And your thing will just, start flying because you use the right kind of trend. And if we can go to the next slide, all of these platforms, they definitely work on something called trends. And it is either something that you create or something that you hop on. So jisko hum matlab bolte hain piggybacking on a trend. So if, you know, something like a trend like recycle, reduce, reuse is already trending, right? And if your domain or your work is in that space, you should just use the hashtag and put out your content also. Similarly, if World Environment Day is trending, that's what a lot of us do, right? And even the worst of brands who are the biggest of polluters, they do write something out on World Environment Day because they know that some audience will, you know, basically trickle down to them as a part of that whole trend. So there's something very important called content buckets. And content can either be news, which is, you know, something that is out there, or something new, which is, you know, fun, or something that no one has seen or heard about. It can be the longest human chain in the history of Mumbai, or it can be, you know, first time that a brand is using all 100% recyclable packaging. So something new. It can be entertaining, right? Something that makes people smile, something that perhaps makes people sad, makes people think. So that's entertainment. And inspiration. We have all been reading about Tulsi Gowraji, right? Who got the Padma Shri. And many such people, many people here and even in the larger panel, we have so many inspiring stories out there. So that is again one of the content buckets. And then we have engagement and conversation. For example, you need not always inform people X, Y, or Z. You can even ask them questions, right? You can ask them something as simple as, do you know what is the length of India's coast? Or do you know at the Conference of Parties 26, what is the degree you know, that all the countries are agreeing to, like 1.5 degree to 2 degrees, what, you know, we want that the temperature should not increase by, or the climate change, to basically control climate change. So when you ask questions that are either simple or something that makes people Google stuff, you have done your job. Even if people don't answer, don't comment, don't share, but if your content makes people perhaps go somewhere else and search for it, I think you've done your job. So that is where, you know, it's very important to know that social media is not always about the likes or the shares that you get. But if you can basically, you know, induce any kind of change in people's minds, your job is done, right? We can go to the next slide. And I'll again request all of you to give me, can we go back? I would request all of you here, any of you, if you have an example that you want to talk me to talk about, please let me know. Else I will go with my own example. So I'm going to talk about how we made content buckets for the Withdraw AIA campaign. But if anyone here wants me to give a live example, I'm happy to do that. I'll wait for 30 seconds. Cool. So I'll talk about the Withdraw EIA campaign that Let India Breathe did. And thankfully, EIA, that is Environment Impact Assessment, is one of the things that applies to all the states in India, applies to all the projects in India. I mean, it used to at least, and applies to all ecosystems. It's not like we have to do EIA only for the forests. You have to do EIA even for the oceans. You have to do an EIA even for a project in the wetlands, right? Anyone here who wants me to talk a little more about EIA, but otherwise you can just Google it up. Environment impact assessment is something that you have to do before any you know, start of any project by a corporate or a government or you know, anybody, to ensure that whatever you're doing is not very harmful to the environment. I mean, that's what it was anyway supposed to be originally. So you basically gauge the amount of environment impact that your project is going to have, right? But last year, we got to know that the EIA is going to be diluted, right? Many more things will be allowed under the EIA and many things will just get cleared, et cetera, et cetera. So that is when a group of us across various organizations came together and spoke about it. But how did it become so big that 2 million mails were sent to the Environment Ministry? How did 20 lakh Indians started, you know, worrying about something as jargon loaded, something as, you know, complicated as EIA, that they sent emails, right? Because we made content buckets. So we realized that EIA is, you know, across ecosystems. So we spoke about marine life, we spoke about leopards, tigers, even, you know, snow leopards, camels. We spoke about riverine stuff like, you know, the Gangetic dolphins. We spoke about wetlands, mangroves. So that is one part. So when we do content bucketing, we basically ensure that we see our product or service or cause from all the directions and basically break it down, right? And ensure that we have one audience at least somewhere or the other. Now, when we talk about all these ecosystems, we also have birders, we have photographers, we have conservationists, we have journalists. So then we realized, okay, these people could be our influencers. Why not reach out to them? Similarly, the Adivasi people or the Koli people or other indigenous, you know, groups that are affected directly when, you know, a project comes in any of these places. So when you map out all of this, you will realize that you have a great network of people and you can either look experts in the domain up or you can reach out to them on, you know, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, etc. Because most of the connections that we made during the campaign, it all happened online. I mean, I would say 100% of it. But again, I will bring back the fact that all this online connections could happen because a lot of us organizations were already involved in grassroots work, right? In my introduction, you saw about Sevare. So many of these activists were either from, you know, grassroots movements in Goa, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Himachal, just name it. So it's very important to have this offline network to ensure that your work flies online. And then you basically, you know, with the help of content buckets, you map out your influencers. You map out the people who you're going to talk to. It can be the minister at the center, but it could also be the minister at the state, right? I mean, during the EIA campaign, someone like Aditya Thackeray also ended up speaking up about it. Mr. Thol from Tamil Nadu, who's an MP, he also spoke up about it. Kanimoli, who's again an MP from Tamil Nadu, she also spoke about it. The Delhi Environment Minister spoke up about it. So it's not necessary that the central law will always only have central figures as your, you know, decision makers. So we targeted...
Question.
Yeah, sure.
How long we will study? When are we going to finish?
Oh, I think we have about 10 minutes.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. That is how you ensure that these are your decision makers. These are the different platforms you talk them, you talk to them with, etc., etc. So we can go to the next slide now. So one very important, you see this graphic again, but this time it has a different meaning. There are two main types of contents, right? Content. One is something that attacks your brain, like facts, figures, data, scientific studies, and, you know, so on and so forth. But the other kind is the content that attacks your heart, right? It can be something, as I mentioned before, inspirational, emotional, something that makes you happy, something that fills you with hope, something that maybe makes you just sad, but not sad enough to give up, sad enough to act, right? So these are the different kinds of content that, you know, plays a big role in any social media campaign. And it can either have a backing of good music, as I mentioned, eardrums. So music is very, very important if you can put it up in a background, you know, on videos, on reels, on memes, etc. And memes these days, especially between the age of 15 to 35, is a big, big thing. Even businesses are using memes basically get their point across. And memes are nothing but popular culture se aapne kuch uthaya and uske basis pe you made a content, right? Meme need not be some film from 2010 or 2020. Even Diwar ka ek dialogue utha kar chipka ke bhi hum ek meme bana sakte hain. You know, Diwar was the movie from I think 70s or something. So it's very important to use pop culture stuff, popular culture stuff like memes and videos, etc., to put your point across. And just the bottom line again, that there are two kinds of content, one that attacks the brain and the second type that, you know, attacks your heart. If you can go to the next slide. Yeah. So these are some questions that, you know, I have myself put up because I have seen these questions come back again and again. To me and to a lot of others. So one of the very key questions here that I put up is, what is a thumbnail, right? So anytime you put up a video online, चाहे वो YouTube पे हो या WhatsApp पे हो या Facebook पर हो या Instagram पे हो, there is a photo that comes right at the start, right? You will see, even जब when you search for a video, you will see a photo that is out there, which is the cover of a video. आप क्लिक करने से पहले जो आपको इमेज दिखती है, जो आपके थंब के नेल को बेसिकली रोकती है स्क्रॉल करने पे, दैट्स कॉल्ड थंबनेल, राइट? सो व्हेन यू पुट अप एनी वीडियो एंड इफ यू हैव स्कोप फॉर पुटिंग अप अ थंबनेल, प्लीज डू इट. एंड जरूरी नहीं है कि वो थंबनेल आप वीडियो में से ही किसी फ्रेम में से निकाले. आई विल शेयर सम एग्जांपल्स शॉर्टली, बट द थंबनेल कैन बी क्रिएटेड आउटसाइड ऑल्सो. And it just has to be something very attractive, very simple, something with minimal words and maximum visual content that makes people understand this is what this video is about and this is why I should, you know, read this video, etc., etc. And that is when, you know, people basically will look at your video, because there is so much clutter out there. Aap apni Facebook feed par ya Instagram feed par agar dekhenge, karodo video hai, right? So why should someone look at your video? That is where thumbnail comes into the picture, right? And you should know the right colors. There should be right kind of contrast. Black ke upar yellow, yellow ke upar black, you know, white ke upar black, stuff like that. If you use the right contrast, your thumbnail will succeed, right? Why should be I on Twitter? I think I have already answered it when I was talking about decision makers, celebrities, journalists, etc. How to use reels. Anyone here who does not know what's a reel? Instagram reel, you can just put it in comments or raise your hand. I'll just assume that all of you do, right? So reels is basically I won't say very new, but in a way a new format of sharing videos. This is basically very, very short content. Initially it used to be only 15 seconds, then it became 30, and now it's 60. I just hope it doesn't go up more than that, because then the whole point is not taken care of. So the key thing about reels is that there is some audio that is already trending, right? It could be music, it could be a dialogue, it could be some very recognizable meme video ka, you know, audio. So people basically use the same trending audio and put their point across, right? So I'm not sure which is the best example here the audience here, but let's talk about dialogues, right? Let's talk about a song. Fir se ud chala jo song hai Rockstar se. It has a certain context, right? The film Rockstar from Ranbir Kapoor. So that music is trending. Now, if I want to put up my content, I will just use the same audio and bring it in my context and put it out there. Right. Again, I will share some examples of good reels and one that Let India Breathe also recently put out. But it's very important to know that stuff like this is taken care of. We use the best kind of tools available to us. For people who do not know this film or the scene that I have put in the comments in the chat, you may not relate, but this is something that we put out about the cop, right? So this is a very trending meme format, but not only the video that is there in this reel, even the audio at the background is an audio that was trending. So basically we did a double whammy. Hamara jo video hai wo bhi ek trending format hai, hamara jo audio hai wo bhi ek bahut trending music hai, and we just put out an environmental context on top of it. And you can see the number of likes it got, the number of comments it got. Partially, it is obviously the smartness of the content that made it trend, but also how the algorithm works, right? When you use a double trending things to ensure that your content is put across, this is the result. This is the ideal result that you will get. So that's about that. Facebook groups ke baare mein maine pehle hi baat kar li thi. And hashtags are something you will see on almost all the platforms. Although Facebook does not really use hashtags for trending these days, but you can also put up hashtags as identifiers. So I think Sprouts ka bhi ek koi hashtag hai, mujhe abhi yaad nahi aa raha hai. I think it's about Mumbai Biodiversity Project. So when you click Mumbai Biodiversity Project in the Facebook search, you will see every post ever put up with that hashtag. So basically, it becomes your own personal museum, right? If you create a unique hashtag of your own business or your campaign, and you keep using it again and again and again, next time you want to tell someone, hey, look me up, you don't have to necessarily give them a website. You just send them this hashtag for Facebook, or you just send them the hashtag link, and your entire work will come for them like a gallery, almost like a free website, right? So that's one very fun way of using a hashtag. Trending वेंडिंग तो ठीक है, Twitter, Instagram वगैरह पर हम दुनिया भर के hashtag डालते हैं ताकि हम trend करें. But this particular tip, I thought I should, you know, pass it on. Next slide, please. And I don't know how much time we have, maybe 5 minutes. But if there are any questions you would want me to answer, I'm happy to talk to you about that.
Participants, are there any questions? Kindly unmute yourself or type that in the chat.
See, all you said was absolutely correct, but then it seems to be a very slow moving process in terms of monetizing and things like that. So do you have any view on these things, especially on YouTube?
Yeah, sure. Two things. People who moved into the YouTube arena, say 5 years ago, they had the first mover's advantage, right? Now it's a whole cluttered space. I mean, you just name it, be it about political commentary or about funny content or about sketches, about indie music. You have at least 100 channels out there who talk about all of these things, right? But for your YouTube to work, it is important for you to have either an offline community or a mailing list or a WhatsApp group or a Facebook group, et cetera, et cetera. So just some couple of tips on YouTube. Use YouTube Shorts as much as possible because it's again a trending format. So do realize that whenever a platform comes up with a new tool or a new format, the more you use it, it will benefit both you and the platform. And that is why when you put out a YouTube Short, abhi to YouTube Short bhi ek saal purana ho gaya, but when you use a trending format that the platform has put out, the platform will push it organically. वो प्लेटफॉर्म चाहेगा कि और भी लोग उसको यूज करें. तो ऑलवेज कीप एन आई ऑन एनी ट्रेंडिंग फॉर्मेट्स दैट अ प्लेटफॉर्म इज कमिंग अप विद, राइट? दैट इज वन. टू, द राइट हैशटैग्स. डोंट क्लटर योर स्टफ विद हैशटैग. इफ योर यूट्यूब चैनल इज टॉकिंग अबाउट इंडियन रेसिपीज, स्टिक टू दैट. डोंट कीप, यू नो, ऑल काइंड ऑफ स्टफ, बिकॉज बेसिकली इट विल क्लटर योर थिंग. एंड येस, इट इज स्लो, बट अगेन थंबनेल्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू हैव द राइट कवर पिक्चर. एंड एज आई मेंशन, make the best of a WhatsApp broadcast list, WhatsApp groups, Facebook groups, and Twitter, and even LinkedIn. And even then build on your personal mailing list, because personal mailing list is the key to all of this. Create a, you know, subscription channel, etc. And because the breakout room is closing, I'll just thank you all. But you can reach out to me on these two email IDs. The second one is more for environmental causes. The first one is something that I use for, you know, personal consultation, etc. And I'm hoping it's correct, right? The breakout room is closing now, do you think?
Yes, it is closing now. Thank you, Yash, for your time.
Thank you, sir.
It may not be a stated agenda, but it is an agenda.
Definitely. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
Welcome back to all the workshop participants. Can you hear me?